Good morning, learners, once again. How are you all? I hope you are all blessed and highly favored. This is your mathematics facilitator, Sir Charles Crum, or you can call me, as you know, Chief Inzonzo in what? Good. We are going to continue from our last week lesson. And last week we started with what? Rounding of numbers. Rounding of numbers. And we are at the rounding of numbers. We looked at one part of it, which was what? Rounding numbers to the nearest thousand. Good. If you look at the previous one that we did, we ran the numbers to the nearest thousand. And we talked about if the number behind is what? Who can tell me? 9, 8, 7, 6, and 5. We add one to it. I hope some of you were wondering what happened if the number behind is 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. What will happen to that one? That's what we are going to look at today. Good. So today we are still under rounding of numbers, but we are looking at rounding numbers to the nearest thousand. And under this list, we are looking at the numbers if the number behind where we are rounding is what? Is 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. What happened to it? So the same steps that we are going to follow for the previous one. So let's read our first step over here. Identify the place you want to round. And as usual, last week we did the same thing. You are always supposed to identify that place. Good. The second one says what? Always check the digit behind the place you want to round. So it means after identifying it, what do? You check what? The digit behind it. Good. And the most important part that we are looking at today is the third point. If the digit behind is 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0, then what should you do? Say, change all the digits to zeros, including the one behind it. So this is a bit different from the one that we did last week. So if the digit behind is 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0, change all the digits behind towards 0, even including the one behind the place that you want to write. So without wasting your time, let's look at the example for today. Good. So round off the following to the nearest thousand. We are rounding off the following numbers over here to the nearest thousand. So let's start. Good. We first of all have to do what? Identify the place we want to round. So we are going to identify our thousand. Take your time and count. Ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. So the digit at the thousand place is what? Is the 2. Then what is the next point? It said check behind the number. So let's check behind. The number behind the 2 is what? Is the 4. The 4 falls in under the category of what? The ones that we are dealing with today, where we are supposed to change everything to 0. So since the number behind is not 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, but it's rather 4, we are going to change everything behind towards 0. So our answer is going to be 3, look at the answer, 6, you write the 2, and the digit behind, including the 4, will change to 0. So we have 0, 0, 0. This is our answer. Let's look at the second example. We are running off to the nearest 1000. Good. So let's identify it. Ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. So the thousand, the digit over there is what? 9. After that, what do you do? Look at them. Check the digit behind it. The digit behind it is what? Is 0. If the digit behind the number that you are running is 0, what do you do? You said that what? What you are supposed to do is to do what? Write your 1, 9, and all the digits behind it should change to 0. So already this one is 0, so we'll write the 0 again. The 3 will change to 0, and the 4 will change to 0. I hope it is clear. Let's look at our last example for today. And you are done. Good. So who can tell me the digits at the 10th place? Very smart one. Is the what? Is the 1. Good. So we have the 1 at the what? The 1000th place. Check the digit behind it. It is what? 4. It is 4. So we have to change everything behind that 1 to 0. So we are going to have 5, 2, 1. You write the 1 and the 4 and the rest of the numbers will change. So the 4 will change to 0, the 6 will change to 0, and the 3 will change to 0. I hope it is clear. Note that we are going to use this principle, the one that we learned last week and this week, to do the rest on Thursday. On Thursday, we are going to round numbers to the nearest 100. And now I'm going to combine everything because now we know the rules. We said that if the digit behind is 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, what do? Add one to the place that you are running and change the rest to 1. 0. Good. Then today we have looked at if the digit behind is what? It's 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. That one you do what? You change all the digits behind the number that you are running to what? 2, 0. So on Thursday, that's what we are going to do. We are going to combine everything. I hope you get it clear. Good. So this brings us to the end of our today's lesson. As usual, assignment will be given to you. Make sure you do it and send it to me on WhatsApp. But remember, you always have to watch the video before you start with the assignment. If you don't understand anything, too, contact me on WhatsApp and I'll be glad to answer you. Okay, see you on Thursday. Bye-bye.